different countries. So can you tell me, do they notice any differences between cosplay in Japan and cosplay in overseas?
キクさんは今まで海外のコスプレ大会に参加したことがありますよね。あ、その海外のコスプレ大会と日本のコスプレ大会の違いは何でしょうか？
海外と日本の違いで、まず何だろう、日本っていうのはそんなにコスプレ大会ってものがあまりないんですよ。で、海外だとそのコスプレ衣装を作って着た後にもその後にこう楽しみ方があるっていうのが一番の大きな違いなんじゃないかなと思います。
Differences in Japan, they wear costumes to the event, but overseas, they like to make the costume and to enjoy wearing the costume too.
それが例えばダンスだったりとか、コスプレファッションショーだったりとか、なんか日本もそういう風にもっとなんかコスプレ着た後にいろいろ楽しんでもらいたいなって思います。
And she hopes to have like more fun events in Japan, like in overseas, like the cosplay fashion show, which is not very common in Japan.
はい、じゃあジャッキーさん、how about you? Do you find any differences between Japan cosplay and overseas cosplay?
キキさんの補足になっちゃうんですけども。日本も昔、大昔はステージとかあったんですけれども、なんていうのかな、16年ぐらい前に、コスプレがすごいアダルトなものとして見られる時期があったんですよ。
アダルトなもの？
はい、ポルノみたいなもの。で、その人たちがやっぱり会場で例えば女の子のいやらしい角度で写真を撮ったりするんで、ビデオを撮ったりするんで、僕たちの世代のイベントをやってる連中がビデオを禁止したんですよ。だから日本は動くことをしないで静止画の文化で育ってしまったんです。
Oh, this is something very interesting. So, Jackie-san's answer is actually something in addition to what Kibi has mentioned. Well, he's saying a very long time ago, close to 20 decades ago, cosplay in Japan, we actually used to have a lot of stage performances, you know, where the cosplayers actually moved around and danced and all that. However, there were a few people, you know, who started taking like sleazy photos of the cosplayers. Sleazy photos. And that's when, you know, people started thinking, maybe this is not too healthy. Okay, and this is the reason why cosplayers in Japan became less mobile. So this is why, compared to overseas, they don't do a lot of like performances, like physical performances, but they're more focused on posing, in front of the camera for still shots. So that is the reason behind the background for Japanese cosplay.
はい。なので、今日本だとワールドコスプレサミットとかで頑張ってるステージに上がってみよう、普通に動いてみようっていう日本人たちが増えてきて、で今その過去の代表なんかを集めてチームジャパンっていうのを作ってですね。今日本で、20分ぐらいかなのステージを作ったりして活動してます。僕はその監督をやってます。
Right, so however things have started changing a little bit. Cosplayers in Japan are starting to, you know, get back to the performance again. And they're actually gathering like Japan representatives from a World Cosplay Summit, and they have formed a team, and they actually are conducting a performance which actually lasts for about 20 minutes. Okay, and Jackie-san is actually directing it.
そうですね。だからあれだよね、キピちゃんが言うように、これからの日本がそう動いて動くコスプレになってって、他の国と一緒になってったら面白いよね。
そうですね。日本とかにはニコニコ動画とかがあるので、踊ってみたとかそういうのに、そのレイヤーさんとかも今住み分けがありますけど、レイヤーさんとかもそういうのにこうアップしたりとかして、自己表現ができたらすごい面白いんじゃないかなって思うんですけど。
So Jackie-san has just mentioned, like, so Kibi, you know, don't you think that it'll be really interesting if, you know, Japanese cosplayers will kind of like, you know, progress to a cosplay, moving cosplay, a performance cosplay? Wouldn't that be really interesting? And Kibi said that now there's a site called Nico Nico Douga where people can upload their dance videos called Otote Mita, and some cosplayers actually move into the Otote Mita side of the fandom, and so Kibi might be interested in uploading some videos of her own. So maybe that's possible evolution for cosplay in future.
私も今コスプレを着て踊ってみたら踊ろうと思って今ダンス練習中です。
あ、she's practicing on dances now.
Wow! Okay, wow!
ぜひ、アップスを見てください。
Oh, she said that she might, you know, take a video of her dancing and upload it on Nico Nico Doga. So, you know, make sure you guys check it out, okay? Okay, so, yes, I've been receiving some questions from the audience.